In this video, we're going to talk about simplifying expressions. And we're going to do that in relation to a CRA sequence of instruction. Specifically, we're going to be looking at the concrete and how that ties up to the abstract. So when we think about simplification of expressions, we're really talking about two things. We're talking about combining like terms, and we're talking about the distributive property. And so those are the two things that we need to be able to model for students to help them simplify an expression. So those are the two that we're going to take a look at, combining like terms and then the distributive property. If we have the expression 2x minus 3 plus 4x minus 6. In this expression, we have four terms, and we're going to model this expression term by term. So we are supposed to model a 2x. And so that is a positive 2x. Now, kids typically see this as a minus 3, but when we are interpreting this term by term, this term is a negative 3. So we are going to model that with 3 negatives. Okay. Then we are supposed to have a positive 4x. That is our next term, so we're going to model that with 4x's. And last, we have negative 6. So that's going to be 6 negatives. So as you can see, once again, we're using our algebra tiles, and our longer pieces represent x. We've modeled each term as it is 2x, negative 3, positive 4x, and a negative 6. Now, to combine like terms, one of the major issues that kids face is that they forget about this negative sign. They move the 6, but the minus sign just stays there. Or they want to put a 3 with a minus 6, and so they'll get negative 3 instead of seeing this as a negative 3 and a negative 6 that are being added together. Here's where the manipulatives help. Because the positive and negative aspect is embedded in the color, in terms of our definition, the negative sign travels with the manipulative. So if we want to show the commutative property, all we have to do is move our pieces. And so just by moving our pieces, and I'm going to keep them separated here for a second, just by moving our sets of pieces, we can see how we reordered this, and we could interpret as a positive 2x, a positive 4x, a negative 3, and a negative 6. And now the sign travels with each term. So it helps reinforce that skill for students. And then when we combine like terms, we use the same rules that we did for adding and subtracting integers. I have positives and positives that I'm adding together. That's just going to give me more positives. So in this case, that's going to be a positive 6x. And I have negatives and negatives that I'm adding together. That's just going to give me more negatives. In this case, a negative 9. So we can see how this model can be used to interpret the expression term by term and then be able to combine like terms. Let's do one more example. In this problem, we're going to start with negative 3x minus 2 plus 4x minus, let's do plus 5. So again, we interpret term by term. We start with the negative 3x, which we will model like this. The next term is a negative 2, so we would model with two negatives. Then we have a positive 4x, which we would model with four blue x's. And last, we have a positive 5, which would be five positive 1s. And so now we've modeled negative 3x minus 2 plus 4x plus 5. Again, to apply the commutative property, all we really do is just move our pieces. Because they're color-coded by sign, when we leave them spaced out, the sign's going to travel with our terms, making that easier for students to see. So if we interpret again, this is a negative 3x plus 4x, a negative 2, and a positive 5. So we can see when we line up our terms, we get negative 3x plus 4x minus 2 plus 5. Of course, to combine like terms, we just push those sets together. And in this case, we get some zero pairs. So just like we did when we were adding integers, our zero pairs are going to cancel out because they have a sum of 0. And so negative 3x and positive 4x is going to simplify to just a positive x. And negative 2 and positive 5, we're going to get 2 zero pairs. And so that's going to simplify to a positive 3. So we can see once again how the use of concrete materials helps us not only use a commutative property, but then also combine those like terms. The second aspect of simplifying expressions that we have to deal with is the distributive property. If we think about the distributive property, 2 times the quantity, 3x minus 1, okay? This is multiplication. So just to recap how we interpret multiplication, whether we're a student first learning it or we're looking at the integers and how we worked with integer multiplication, we said that 2 times 3 was two groups of 3. So the first factor indicated how many groups, and the second factor is what was in each group. That is going to be the same definition here. So when we model the distributive property, we are going to model two groups of 3x minus 1. Okay, so that's going to be two groups of 3x minus 1, which would be 3x and a negative 1. There's one group. And 3x and a negative 1. And the way that we interpret that helps to solidify that students are going to multiply every term in that binomial. We know one of the issues that students face when they first learn the distributive property is they don't multiply each term in that quantity. So by handling this as two groups of 3x minus 1, we're going to make sure that we account for all of those terms two times. Then, of course, to combine like terms, we would push the like terms together, and we see that we get 6x minus 2. We can interpret the distributive property a little bit differently as well. We know we don't always want students to see two groups of 3x minus 1. We want them to think about it as two groups of 3x and two groups of negative 1. Once we have the model established with two groups of 3x minus 1, we correct for them missing a term, potentially. Then we can transition to two groups of 3x and two groups of negative 1. Which is more the distributive property, I think, generally how we think about it in algebra. So two groups of 3x, there would be a group of 3x, and here's another group of 3x. So two groups of 3x gives me 6x's. And then two groups of negative 1 would give me the negative 2. So it changes the way we model just a little bit because we've changed the language and we've changed the thought process. So two different ways to think about distribution. This is two groups of the quantity 3x minus 1 where we lay them both out and then we use the commutative property. Or we can do two groups of 3x and then two groups of negative 1. So that looks nice and neat when we're distributing a positive, but we know one of the issues that students face when they're using the distributive property, besides missing terms, they forget to carry that sign. So if we were dealing with the expression negative 3 times the quantity x plus 1, how do we handle that? I'd ask you to recall multiplication of integers. When the first term was negative, if it was negative 2 times 3, we can't do negative 2 groups of 3. So what we did is we thought about this negative being factored off. And we said we'll handle that negative 1 as the opposite of two groups of 3. And that's exactly what we're going to do over here. So instead of three groups of x plus 1, we're going to have the opposite of three groups of x plus 1. So if we were modeling that, I would have x plus 1, x plus 1, and x plus 1. But again, I don't want that. I want the opposite. And now I can combine like terms, and we see how we get negative 3x and a negative 3, which gives us the expression negative 3x minus 3. Okay. Again, we could handle this distribution term by term. It would just change the way we modeled a little bit. If we were going to distribute the negative 3 to each term in the quantity, we would say this is the opposite of 3 groups of x. So we would do 3 groups of x, and then we would do the opposite of that. We would do the opposite of 3 groups of 1. So here would be 3 groups of 1. And then we would do the opposite of that. Both models will lead us to the simplified expression negative 3x minus 3.